Welcome my dear friends, this video is about the computer network. Few topics we have already studied in the part 1, that is computer network 1, and further few more topic I am going to discuss in this topic, that is computer network 2. In this session you will learn about the types of network. So first of all you should know that what is network. As you all know that network is the interconnection of something. If I am talking about network of the friends, it means there is a link between you all friends, and this link is called the network. In the same way, if we are creating the link between the computer networks or between the computers, then this type of network is called the computer network. Means when we are connecting two or more than two computers in a chain, and these computers are able to transfer the data from one system to another system, then this type of structure is known as computer network. So now moving forward, I want to say that the types of the network can be described in many forms, such that according the area of the network, the size of the network, the total number of computer system attached in the network, the geometrical structure of the network, and many other issues also. So in this session I am going to tell you about the network that are depend upon the size of the network, means the area covered by the network. So moving forward, the first network that I am going to discuss, that is local area network. So the local area network comprises the term local, means this is a network that covers the local area, means the area nearby area in a smaller distance. So as you can see, the smaller area such as the building and office, means if we have one story, two story, three story building and we want to establish a network in this building, then this network is called the local area network. So the communication medium in this network is twisted pair and the coaxial cable. So it means the LAN is a wired network, means the computer in this networks are connected with the help of wires. You can easily see the twisted pair and the coaxial cable in your home also. There is a wire that which are twisted. It is a twisted of two wires of usually green or black, yellow or red. So this is the type of wire that you can see at your home, and coaxial cable can be seen in the dish TV connection. So that comes from the dish to your TV. So on these two wires can be easily seen at your homes also. First of all, it is a wired network, and the area of the network is low, so it is a less costly network. Means you don't need most expensive hardware. So this is a less costly network. Now moving further, this is a wired network and covering a less area, so this is the faster network, and it provides high security, because if there is a wireless connection, it may be a chance there is a leak of data, but when the data is moving through any wired connection, there is no chance of the leaking of the data easily. The data cannot be leaked easily. So LAN is a network that provides higher security. In the starting, where there was no existence of any personal area network, the limitation of the LAN was approximate 10 kilometers, but somewhere you can see the range of the LAN becomes the 50 kilometers nowadays. Now moving forward, this is the PAN, means personal area network. This network can be easily seen at any place, at your home also, in a room also. For example, if there is a hotspot connection in any one's mobile and other's tab or laptop is connected with that hotspot, so this is a type of PAN or personal area network. For example, if you have Wi-Fi connection at your home and your phone, more than two or three phones, a laptop and a printer is connected through each other with the help of that Wi-Fi, so this is also a type of network. So PAN is a type of network, and the personal area networks cover the area of 3 feet, means the range of the PAN is what, 30 feet. So this is a very common network we can usually see. And who was the scientist? Thomas Zimmerman was the first research scientist to bring the idea of the personal area network. Now moving forward, the types of networks means there are two types of personal area networks can be available. First is wireless, that what we are using right now, means wireless personal area network by adopting using wireless technologies such as Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Means if we have Wi-Fi, Bluetooth microphone is available or earplugs are available and the phone is keeping at some distance, then this type of network is called wireless. And when we are using the earplug and we are also connecting a network, so this type of network is called the wired network. So the PAN is of two types. First is wireless, in which we are not using any type of wire and we are connecting through the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And the second one is wired personal area network. It means we are connecting through the USB devices. Now moving forward, the next is example of the personal area network. So that I had told you earlier, there are many other networks that we can see in our home at our around. So this type of network is called personal area network that you can see here. Suppose that body area network, it means that networks moves with a person. For example, a mobile networks move with a person. Suppose a person establish a network connection and then create a connection with another device to share the information, for example share it. Now offline network or offline network can be created inside the home. The example is already given to all. And the next is a small home office in which you can have Wi-Fi calling, you can have Wi-Fi connection. So this type of network is called the personal area network. The next is metropolitan area network. So this is a network having the big capacity than the LAN and PAN. In this network, usually this type of network covers the whole city. Means in the earlier, nowadays we will have the dish antenna at your homes, but in the starting when we have only the cable connections, so the metropolitan area used to create the cable connection. Usually there were one or two or three service provider, and those service provider having a hub or the connection between the each and every houses of the city. So this type of area in which we are covering usually a city, then this type of network is called the metropolitan area network, or you can say MAN. Simply it is say MAN. Now moving forward, use of metropolitan area. First you can see MAN is used to communicate between the banks in a city. Means there are more or two, three or four branches in a big city, then you can have metropolitan area to establish a network between the branches. So there are some more examples are given. It can be used in airline reservation. It can be used in college within a city. It can be used for communication in a military. It means it covers a larger area than the LAN. And you can also say, according to the previous theories, when a network covers the whole city, then this type of network is called the metropolitan area network. Now moving forward, this is the next and last network area, the what we are using right now. This is internet, and the internet comes under the type that is WAN, means wide area network. So this is a bigger network than the LAN. So a wide area network is not limited to a single location, but it spans over a large geographical area through a telephone line, fiber optics, cable, or it may also be connected with the help of satellite links. And as I told you earlier, that the internet is one of the biggest WAN in the world. So if a question is asked to you all that what is the biggest WAN, the answer will be the internet. So the wide area network is widely used in the field of business, government and education. Now moving forward, we will have the examples of the wide area network. So what are the examples of the wide area networks? Means any private networks, means the networks provided by any business family or any bank especially. The telecom network, suppose that we are having different types of telecom sectors such as Reliance, Jio, Vodafone, and each and every network has its own wide area network. So this type of networks are called wide area networks, and these are the main examples of this network also. So now, what are the advantages of wide area network? First of all, the geographical area means it covers the large geographical area, means there is no need to create small networks, many small networks in order to collect the larger area. We will have a single large network in order to cover a large geographical area. And when we are covering a large geographical area with a single network, means the data is centralized, means we do not have need to buy the emails, files and backup of the server, means the data is centralized, means when any person needs the data, he or can get from a dedicated service, means we are using the Google to just fetch the data from the server. The all type of data is centralized in their dedicated servers. Now, get updated files means there are many software companies that are working on that. Live servers mean they are regularly updating the servers. They are regularly in the search of the journals, the topics, the issues that are written in the form of any particular topic. So that software engineers are used to just keep fetching the data and just loading on the server. So can when we are searching any particular data, we will get the updated data from the server. Now next is exchange message. So this is as simple as that, so that you can easily exchange your message from one place to another with the help of WhatsApp, with the help of Telegram channels, with the help of Gmails, emails. So there are variety of the messenger services are also available through which you can exchange your data easily. Now, sharing of the software resources means if we can share the software like hard drive, RAM, and also now we have the many cloud services also available. Suppose that Gmail is providing the Google Drive. As there are many advantages with wide area network, there may be some disadvantages also. So the first disadvantage of wide area network, that are the security issues or the security concerns. Means the security issues are at the higher side as compared with the LAN and MAN networks. Means when we are working on the internet, there may be issues of the hackers, crackers, viruses and many other type of disturbing elements also. So in order to make clear the security issues, we need firewalls and many antiviruses software, so the hackers and the crackers are not allowed to reach our systems. Now the setup cost is also higher because we need to purchase the router, switch and many other complex devices to set up the network. And the next is troubleshooting problems, means the wide area network is covering a larger area. So it is difficult to find the area of the problem and also to repair the problem. Now these are the networks which are divided on the basis of the area covered by them, such as PAN. PAN, it can be easily seen at any small place at our home also. The LAN is used for the small offices located in a building or nearby. The next is MAN. MAN is for the metropolitan area. It is covering the whole city, and this type of network can be found when there are many branches of a bank in a big city and they want to create a network between these banks. So this type of network can be seen in this location. And the last is the wide area network, and the wide area network is internet, that what we are using in our daily life, and the internet is the biggest example of the WAN. So now moving forward, we will have the term topology. What is topology? When we are connecting a network or establishing a network, there may be some geometrical representation through which we can connect our computer. It means the appearance in which we are setting our computer, or what are the diagram of the computer when we are connecting them. So there are many topologies available. So there is tree, mesh, bus, start, hybrid, and I will discuss one by one. Now moving first, we have mesh topology. So as its name implies, it means this is a mesh. So what is mesh? In this type of topology, each device is connecting to every other device on the network through a dedicated point to point link. It means when we suppose that we have 6 to 7 computer networks and all computer networks are connecting to each other dedicatedly, means if the computer number 1 wants to send data to computer number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, the computer number 1 can directly send the data to the other computers. There is no need to send the data from any other network also. So this is a mesh topology. In this topology, if the network fails or if any connection fails, the whole data transmission will not suffer. It means the particular system of which network or which wires failed, that only that system will not able to communicate with other system. Rest of the system will be communicating in the same manner as they were communicating before. So if there are n devices in a network, and then each device must be connected with n minus 1 devices. Are you getting my point? Thus, I want to say, if there are 6 computer, then all the 6 computers are connected with the rest of the 5 computers. Now this is a diagram of the mesh topology. In this diagram, you can say there is a wired connection between all the other computer systems, means each and every computer is connected to the other system, and each and every computer is able to send data from one system to another system. So what are the advantages? As I told you earlier, so no data traffic issues, and there is a dedicated line between two devices. It means when there are separate line and any computer is sending to data any other computer, so as they have dedicated line, so there is no any type of data traffic issues occurs. Next, it is a reliable. As I told you earlier, it means the failure of one link does not affect other links and the communication between one device to another device. You can understand it more clearly with this example. If there is connection between system number 1 to system number 2 and system number 1 to system number 3, and the link between the system number 1 and system number 2 gets failed, then the computer number 1 is still send the data to the computer number 3. Means only the communication between the system number 1 and system number 2 is affected. Means this is a reliable topology in which the communication is not stopped by any failure. Mesh topology is secure. Means it is secure because it is point to point data communication. Means there is a single way from the sender to the receiver. And fault detection is easy. So as you can assume, if you cannot able to send data from one system to another system, it means it is very clear that is the fault is between that two systems only. So in the mesh system, the main point is to memorize is that in the mesh system, each system is connected with the other system in a network. Now moving to the next topology. The disadvantage can also be discussed, that the amount of wires required to connect each system is tedious and headache. Means there are dedicated connections, means the wire requirement is at higher side, so the amount of wires is also at the higher side. Now since each device needs to be connected with other devices, means the number of IO ports are much required. The next is star topology. So in star topology, each device in a network is connected to a central device called hub. Means in the star topology, as you can see in the diagram, there is a central device named hub, and each and every device is connecting to that device. This is called hub. As you can see,
द सिस्टम नंबर 1 इज कनेक्टेड टू द हब, द सिस्टम नंबर 2 इज ऑल्सो कनेक्टेड, सिस्टम नंबर 3 इज कनेक्टेड, सिस्टम नंबर 4 एंड सिस्टम नंबर 5. एंड एज यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन द सिस्टम. द ईच एंड एवरी कम्युनिकेशन इज गोइंग थ्रू दैट पर्टिकुलर हब. मीन्स इफ अ पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम वॉन्ट्स टू सेंड डेटा टू एनी सिस्टम, द डेटा विल फर्स्टली सेंड टू द हब एंड फ्रॉम द हब द डेटा इज सेंड टू दैट रिक्वायर्ड सिस्टम. सो दिस इज द ज्योमेटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द स्टार टोपोलॉजी. सो इन दिस टोपोलॉजी वॉट विल हैपन, इन दिस टोपोलॉजी इफ द हब fails, then the whole communication or the whole data transfer becomes fail. But if any particular system fails, the communication remains as it was earlier because the communication is done with the help of the hub. As you can see in the example, it is written here, the star topology does not allow direct communication between our devices. Our devices must have to communicate through hub. Means if one device wants to send data to other device, it has to first send the data to the hub and then the hub transmit that data to the designated device that I told you earlier. Now this is the diagram, and moving forward, the advantages. First of all, less expensive because the wires are used is on the lower side. Next, this is easy to install. And this is robust also, means if one links fail, other links will work just in as their previous way. Fault detection is also easy, means if a link fails, it can be easily identified. Now there are few disadvantages about the star topology. As you can see in the diagram that all the communication is going through the hub. So hub is the central device of this topology. So if the hub becomes failed, then what will happen? Then the whole network does not be able to work. So a hub requires more resources and the regular maintenance in order to work properly because it is the central system of the star topology. So you can say the whole communication of the star topology, it depends upon the hub. So in the hub, in this topology, the hub is the important part of the topology. Now moving forward, this is the bus topology, and this is the most easier and the simple technology to understand, because in this topology, all the computer systems, first you can see the diagram, all the computer systems are connected with a single line, and this single line is known as usually bus and the computer organization. So you can say that this type of topology is called the bus topology. So in this topology, the data moves from this direction to this direction, or either in this direction to this direction, depend upon the architecture used. So if this computer system wants to send data to this computer system, then the communication of the data is going through in this way. The data first reaches to this system and then reaches to this system. So according to the diagram, you can understand if the main wire, that is this wire, becomes failed, means the whole communication will stop. And as you can see in the diagram also, this devices is also tap that connect a drop line to the main cable, since all the data is transmitted over the main cable. So this is only the limit of the drop line and the distance of the main cables have, because there is a limitation that at which distance a data can travel. So this is the diagram that which I had discussed earlier. Now there are few advantages and disadvantages. The advantages of this technology is that the installation is easy. So there is no much requirement of the data cable, and this data cable is called the backbone of the cable, and less data cable is required than the mesh and star topology. And what is the disadvantage of this topology? Means there is a single cable, so it is difficult to detect the fault that at which place the fault occurs, because if at any position the fault will occur, it is sure that the whole communication will stops. And not scalable as there is a limit of how many nodes or can connect with the backbone. Means if you want to add some more nodes, if you have to increase the length of the backbone or the cable also. So the next topology is a ring topology. At its name identifies the term ring. So the geometrical representation of this topology is look like a ring. So with the help of this definition, you can understand that this structure forms a link. Thus, it is known as the ring topology. If a device wants to send data to another device, it sends the data into the one direction. Each device in a ring has a repeater. And if the received data is intended for the other device, then the repeater forwards this data until the intended device receives it. Now, it can be much understandable with the help of the diagram also. You can see all the computers are making a ring type structure in this topology. So now try to understand that what I want to say. This particular system can send data in one direction only, means in this direction only. And if this system wants to send data to this particular system, then what will the communication type and how the communication will occur? So first of all, this system will send data to this system. This system will check then the data is for itself or for any other system. If the data is not intended for this device, it will amplify the data so that the data can move forward and again resend the data to the next system. Again, the system will check that this message is for that particular system or not. If not, then what will happen? It will again amplify the data and send forward. In the similar way, the data is checked by this system also and then again resend, and when the data reaches to this system, the system receives the data and the no any further resend of the data may occur. So this is the working technology of the ring topology. So what are the advantages? As you can see in the figure, it is easy to install and it is easy to add or remove any device from the topology because only two links are required to change. As you can see in the diagram, if I want to remove this system, only this link and this link will be affected. And if I want to add a new system in this place, this particular link only be affected by adding or removing the data. Now, what is the disadvantage? A link failure can fail the entire network as the signal will not travel forward due to the failure. As you can see in the diagram or according to the previous explanation, if any particular link will fail, the data will not be able to reach to the desired system or to the location. So the data traffic issues can also occur. Means, what is the means of data transfer? Suppose that this system forwarded a data, this system also sent some own data, and this system also sent own data, then there may be a data traffic issue also. So these are the disadvantages of the ring topology. The next is hybrid topology. Means hybrid topology is a combination of the two or more topology. Means there may be a combinations of the topology. So how it can be happened? As you can see in the figure, this is a hybrid topology. In this topology, two other topology, means the ring topology and this is the star topology, are connected to each other to create a whole network. Means this is a whole network and this network is a combination of the two different types of network. And in these two different types of network, the two different topologies has been followed. In the first one, the ring topology, and in the next one, the star topology. As the many other networks has the advantage and disadvantage, is the similar way the hybrid network has also some advantages and disadvantages. The main advantages of the hybrid network is that we can connect two different networks each other while they are following some different types of topologies. Means it is easy to connect two networks and the next one that we can extend it further or we can connect it to any other network following some other type of topology. And when we are using a hybrid topology, there may be some disadvantages also. The main disadvantages are that the fault detection, installation and the complex is maintenance, because when we are using two or more than two types of topology, it is all the factors being complicated in order to manage. So in this session, I had told you some important topics about the types of networks such as LAN, MAN, PAN, WAN and the topologies about how the systems can be connected in order to form a network. Thank you for this session.